Welcome back, warriors. Kwe Tunse Sego. My name is Pam Palmiter, and this is my YouTube channel where we focus on educating the resistance and inspiring the next generation of warriors to help us protect our people and the planet. 2019 was the year Canada's genocide against Indigenous women and girls was exposed to the whole world. So what's in store for 2020? Armed Native Resistance. Stay tuned till the end of this video to find out more. Was a powerful year. Some might argue a turning point in some respects. The world is now entirely aware of the impending climate disaster if we don't take radical steps to stop the damage. Social media has forever changed the political landscape. No longer can governments hide critical information from its citizens. In even the most restrictive countries, citizens find a way to link up and share information. Information and knowledge is power. Corruption, collusion, scandals, and crimes are being laid bare in all levels of government. The world that has been artificially created by those in power is now being dismantled by the people. And here in Canada? For decades, Canada has bragged to the world about how it is a champion of multiculturalism, human rights, and Indigenous rights. It has been the first to criticize other countries guilty of horrendous human rights violations and genocides. And I'm not saying that's wrong. In fact, I think all states have a legal and moral obligation to call out genocide and take steps to stop other states from doing it. What I'm upset about is that Canada has failed in a very profound way to account for its own historic and ongoing human rights violations and genocide. Indigenous peoples have been calling out Canada's genocide for decades without any substantive action from any level of government or political party. Then, in June 2019, the National Inquiry into Murdered and Missing Indigenous Women and Girls found, as a matter of fact and law, that Canada was guilty of both historic and ongoing genocide against Indigenous women and girls. Canada had more than half a year to stand up, take full responsibility, and engage in immediate, urgent, and crisis-level response to end the genocide. Instead, we were subjected to no end of genocide explainers, reducers, excusers, fence-sitters, and deniers in the media, academia, and at all political levels. 2019 is the year of shame for Canada. In 2019, I traveled with Cher McIver and other Native activists to Washington to testify before the Inter-American Commission on Human Rights. We were there to ask them to help us oversee a transitional justice plan to end genocide in Canada. Canada's officials were there, and their response was that we're in the middle of an election and we can't act. Imagine Canada could not act to end the rapes, murders, exploitation of Indigenous women and girls by the thousands because of an election? Do you think any so-called modern democratic country would accept that as an excuse from any other country that was committing genocide? Of course not. If another country declared war on Canada during an election, do you think Canada would sit on its hands? Of course not. But when it comes to the deaths of Indigenous women and girls, and indeed all Indigenous peoples, despite the fact that it was 2019, Canada has no end of excuses. And it has never mattered which political party is in power. The lives of Indigenous women and girls are still rendered less worthy of urgent protection. And for this reason, Canada should look back on 2019 as its year of shame. There are not enough words, meetings, selfies, or initiatives that Prime Minister Trudeau can point to offset its complete and utter inaction on genocide in Canada. However, Canada's shame is not the only story for 2019. We also have to look at it from a First Nations perspective. And when we do that, 2019 was a year filled with grassroots Native resistance, resurgence, revitalization, and rebuilding. 2019 was the year of the warrior. It was a year of grassroots people asserting, living, and defending our sovereignty and our nations in the face of Canada's powerful, oppressive genocide machine. It was a year where Native youth stood out as leaders, international world leaders, and Native women activists and families continued to push for justice regardless of what their political leaders were doing. Yes, it's true, some of our political organizations continue to be barriers to real change on Turtle Island, but we shouldn't lose hope. Grassroots peoples have shown us that the real power of our nations is in our people. It's in ourselves. One person can make a difference. Think of all of those people in our nations and in our communities who are working hard to educate and empower one another in our First Nations, in our local communities, in our clans and houses, urban communities, and all throughout social media, we reach out to one another. Think about those filing claims against Canada in Canadian courts and tribunals, but also international human rights treaty forums and tribunals, all seeking justice and to protect our rights. Think about those risking their own safety and freedom to defend our lands, waters, and peoples against pipelines, mines, and other destructive and polluting practices. There are many people fighting to rid our First Nation governments and political organizations of colonial laws and practices, the influence of government, and seek to restore traditional laws and values which centered the voices of our people. There are so many people working overtime to represent the authentic Native voices of our people in mainstream media, social media, radio, TV, and in the arts. Look at all of those who are advocating strenuously and relentlessly with the conviction of our ancestors for our Native rights and who refuse to sell out, who refuse to bow to political pressure, and who refuse to settle for anything less than our people deserve. There are so many who are finding their ways through all of the trauma, navigating a racist system and overcoming relentless injustice, to try to raise loving, healthy children, volunteer in our communities to help take care of our elders, walking the streets to provide for the homeless, and always keeping a lookout for our people, whether they be in our First Nations or in urban centers. All of these people are warriors. You are all warriors. And our future is based on that. To imagine that our people continue to warrior on despite ongoing genocide and the powerful corporate and government forces that keep trying to push us back is nothing short of heroic. 500 years of colonization and genocide has taken a huge toll on our populations and our spirits, but it hasn't smothered the fire within. 2020 will be the year of armed Native resistance. Our people will be armed with renewed faith in our sovereignty as individuals to take back our lives, our governments, and our futures. Our people will be armed with the wisdom of our ancestors, passed down through all of our customs and practices, through our aunties, uncles, parents, and elders. Our people will be armed with the strength that comes from our languages, our practices, our laws, and all of our traditional ways. We will be armed with the pride that comes from our identities as Mi'kmaq, Anishinaabeg, Wolastoq, Cree, and Haudenosaunee. And when the Canadian state attempts to confront us with their violence on the ground, we will be ready. We will be armed with our drums, our feathers, and our spirit. We are Idle No More. We are Resistance 150. We are Occupy INAC. We are the resistance. 2019 was the year of shame and genocide for Canada, but for us, 2019 was the year of the warrior. And 2020 promises to be the year of armed Native resistance. First Nations armed with the strength, determination, and commitment to protect our lands, waters, and people. Armed with the love and peace that's in the spirit of our treaties. And more settler and international allies have joined us in this fight for social justice and earth justice. It's amazing our treaty partners are stepping up and assuming their roles in this. 2020 could be the year that turns out that we change everything together as First Nations and treaty partners. Let's make that our treaty resolution for 2020. Thank you all for watching my channel. If this is your first time here, please consider subscribing and sharing these videos. We need to get the word out. I'm trying to get to 10,000 subscribers in 2020 to help us spread the knowledge. And don't forget to check out my podcast show, Warrior Life, because I have amazing interviews with some of the leading Native warriors all over Turtle Island and both Canada and the United States. We can learn so much from them and their experiences. You can also check out my blog, Indigenous Nationhood, where I post information, analysis, and commentary on current political and legal issues facing Native peoples all over Turtle Island. And what I'll do is I'll post the show notes for this video in my blog for those who prefer written information. You can access all of my blogs, podcasts, and videos from my website, www.pampalmeter.com. And for those of you who would like to support independent Native media across a variety of platforms, you can check out my Patreon account in the description box below. Till next time, stay alert, warriors. 2020 is going to be our year.